Hey guys, it's Mia Yis, and today I'm going to do Josh's Melon book tag. I was tagged by my friend JD Estrada. I'm putting a link to his video and the original down below. Okay, so let's get to it. I have to put that down. That is hot. Ooh, hot tea. Okay. Number one, watermelon. What is your ideal place to read in summer and what kind of book? So for me, I would like to have a big screened-in porch because I don't like all the bugs attacking me. Mosquitoes like to eat me. They think I'm really sweet for some reason. Bees like to sting me. I don't know. I like to enjoy the breeze and all that nice stuff, but in a way that all the insects can get at me. What kind of book? I don't know. It just depends. Anything that is interesting. I have so many different kinds of books that I like to read, so I don't know. I can't pick one. Number two, Cantaloupe, a sweet, good-hearted character. Okay, so Hagrid from Harry Potter, so sweet. And Diana Barry from Anne of Green Gables. That was Anne Shirley's best friend, and she was certainly a sweet girl. not as mischievous as Anne, that's for sure. Okay, number three, Honeydew, a work recommended to you by a spouse or partner. For me, that is The Elegant Universe by Brian Greene. I hadn't even heard of Brian Greene before I got this recommendation, and now I really like Brian Greene. I've watched, he had a series about string theory. We watched that. I read his books. Yeah, Brian Greene. Let's see, number four, Horned Melon. A great work written by a writer outside of their main genre. So, Coraline by Neil Gaiman. I think that usually when I think of Neil, I don't think of children's book, but he wrote it and I thought it was awesome. I love that story. Really good story. Cassava, I hope I'm saying that right. A dry work with a strong message. This is one of my favorite books, but it's really dry and out there. It is The Origin of Consciousness in the Breakdown of the Bicameral Mind by Julian James. And so basically it is a hypothesis in psychology that the human mind once had two parts, and one part of the brain would be speaking, and so that's what people thought was the God part. They thought it was God because it was their brain speaking to them. And then the second part listened and obeyed the subconscious, what is now the subconscious mind, but the mind, the other part of the mind that was telling them things. Bicameralism. Anyway, it's pretty interesting concept. I really like that book. I think it's really interesting, but you can look up that and more about it. It's pretty dry, but there you have it. let's see, Crenshaw, a book of multiple stories that does a great job connecting as one. Violent Ends, which is a young adult anthology that is about a school shooting, and so it has all of these different authors writing a character that is involved in the school shooting from their point of view, and then by the end of it you kind of have a better picture of what was happening from all these different perspectives. So that was pretty interesting concept and delivery. Number seven, Canary Melon, a work that gave a strong warning. Animal Farm by George Orwell. If you haven't read that book, read it. Okay, let's move on to Santa Claus, a great book you got as a Christmas Hanukkah holiday present. So I got The Little Prince in Italian, which I was thrilled. I thought that was the coolest thing. I still think it's the coolest thing. I love it. So I have all these different versions of The Little Prince now, and I have an Italian version. And I also got a book of jazz piano, like a music theory book, which I really like. Number 9, Winter Melon. Which work makes you feel the coldest? Stuart M. Kaminsky has a series that is like a Russian detective novel series, and so he's describing Russia and Siberia and cold, cold stuff. Let's see. Number 10, Golden Prize, an award winner from the last year that you want to read. This is tough because I don't ever pay attention to book awards. Perhaps I should, but I looked it up and I found that there is a romantic suspense Rita award-winning book called Flash Fire by Dana Martin that I would be interested in reading. There you go. Let's see. Number 11. What is your favorite melon? Oh, so hard. I love melon. So I love watermelon. I love honeydew. I love cantaloupe. I don't know. Maybe it's watermelon, honeydew, and cantaloupe. I don't know. That's tough. Basically, what I do when I'm picking a melon is just I go around and I look and I try to find the one that looks the best, the ripest and most yummy melon, and that's the one I get. So could be any of those as long as it looks good. Nice for a melon. Okay, I am going to have my tea now. This is good temperature. I hope that you have tea too, and I will talk to you next time. Goodbye.